sure.
Good to see you, first off.
I'm fine. Thank you.
Hey, so it kind of caught me off guard. Oscar saying he wants to fight Canelo. Have you talked to him about this?
Yeah, he also said Mayweather.
Yeah.
So I think that Mayweather fight would be better for him than Canelo. I think Canelo is a little too big right now. But look, Oscar is for me. So I'm not surprised that he take on a challenge of somebody that he know that he has to be mentally and physically ready for. I mean, look at his career. Look at the divisions in every division, not every division, but look at the divisions that he actually accomplished the world title in, over seven. So, I mean, that's him. But not
crazy?
Me.
Is it crazy though? Is it crazy for him to say someone like Canelo? Like a lot of people are like, what are you talking about?
Well, I don't know. You got to ask his motive. I mean, there's, you know, one thing I learned about boxing, there's nothing really crazy. It's sort of something that you got to understand. There's a cause and an effect, and there's a reason that made that become a conversation to people and himself. I guess my whole thing is a fighter would never submit to that he's not able to do what he's done for so long.
Yeah.
Now, when the reality kicks in, first round, second round, third round, then you don't see history making in that moment. You see the history of what it really doesn't do. Make you stronger, make you better, and make you wiser. You know what I mean? So everybody got a reason why they want to do things. I always had a reason. And we got to ask them what's their reason.
Have you had a chance to ask them, like, hey, what's your reason for
this? No, because I had a lot of people tell me what I shouldn't do. I went against the grain. Some would give me the kudos and say I was lucky. I said 10 times, 15 times, 12 times. I mean, I think it comes to the point where I don't feel if myself be the person that says what a person shouldn't do would be a hypocrite. And it would be hypocritical for me to go and now become that and still think people are gonna respect what I say. Because I'm like this, you think you can do it and you really, really believe it and you put the work ethics into it and you already have, which most people don't have in boxing, the percentage is very small, a legacy that can at least have people thinking, maybe he can, maybe he can't. Then do what you do until you can't do it no more. But I'm definitely not in that mind frame because you've been asked. I know you didn't ask, but it's been asked.
No, I asked you.
Yeah, it's been asked. I mean,
oh, yes,
but it was ironic is,
yeah.
I just want to speak on one more. What is ironic, and not even ironic, what is like kind of like being overlooked and underappreciated, I think that's the proper word to use, sentence. I stopped boxing at 52 when those are coming back after being inactive for over 10 years, which is a long time. And it's become a frenzy and also a shit show. Boy, how we forget that less than 5 years ago, the alien, B-Hop, the executioner, won titles in his 50s and 40s and was defending them. But all of a sudden, 5 years or less, might be off a month or two, this frenzy then took over as a plague, pandemic. And they forgot about me and what I done. That quick. It ain't personal, it's the way it is. People have short memories until others remind them. And us, I'm guilty of it too. oh, I'm absolutely guilty of it. Years ago, it's been 20 years, I've been guilty of it. Let me make that clear. But I understand it. I also know that I can help somebody else right now and actually speak about it and let them understand, like, you know what? I didn't even think of that. You know, I'm so caught up in, this guy is 47. Just turned a baby 52. Don't you know B-Hop was defending titles in his 50s?
Against guys in the
Don't prime. You know this guy, Bernard, was in Canada doing push-ups in a fifth round while a young guy that's 20-plus years younger?
Let me ask you on him.
Oh, wait a minute.
Yeah.
Who's been motivated by the grandfather energy juice that Bernard drank is called life? His name is Gene Pascal.
He got popped before his fight with Badu Jack with like 4 or 5 substances. You fought him. 2 questions. One, did you have a suspicion at all that he was involved in that kind of stuff?
No, he kept telling me take the shot. I mean, not the shot. Don't bloop that out. I need that to go viral. No, let me tell you something.
That'll be the quote, the title.
Everybody know about that shot. But listen, I'm still trying to get away from it. But look, let me tell you something. No, take it if you need it. But look. Now, he's been banned or he's been accused of using banned substance by the WBC?
Levada.
Okay. Yeah. Damn, Gene. He was telling me I was a cheat. You remember that? He was telling me to take the test, not the shot, the test. Look at the fight, man. Go back, look at the second fight. Before the Quebec the first time, second fight was in Montreal. That's when I did the push-ups. Yeah. Come on, classic. They told me to take the test. That was the sound pitch. I was really disappointed that he didn't take the damn. I mean, I was disappointed that they took the test. So I'm like, yo, like, but, you know, I'm just hoping there's a whole mix-up, you know, that sort of he got to straighten out. I don't wish ill will on nobody. I like a Pascal. We become distant, respectful, I can say associates. I respect him, he respects me when he see me. I'm in Canada or he's in Miami. Hey, I ain't got no problem with it, but I was kind of like, oh, he was back then, now maybe he should have been taking the test. So
thank you so much for watching this video and make sure to subscribe for more videos of your favorite fighters over here on Fight Up TV, and give us a follow online as well at Fight Up TV on Twitter and on Instagram. We appreciate it, guys.